So let's understand exactly what happens during a page fault service. So when a thread is executing on the CPU, it generates a virtual address, and the hardware takes that virtual page number and looks up the TLB to see if it can translate that virtual page to a physical page frame that contains the contents of that page. Now, if the TLB lookup fails, that's a miss in the TLB. And at that point, the hardware, if the hardware is doing the page table lookup, it'll go to the page table and look up the page table to see if the mapping between the virtual page and the physical page is in the page table. And this would have been there if the operating system has already put the contents of that page in physical memory. But if the operating system has not brought in that page from the disk into physical memory, then when the hardware goes and looks into the page table, it may not find the mapping between the virtual page and the physical frame. And so that will result in a page table miss. And that miss is the point at which you have a page fault. So your page fault now that says that I don't have the page in physical memory. And so what the operating system at that point in the handler, what it has to do is to locate where on the disk that particular page, virtual page, is residing on the disk. And as part of the page fault service, the operating system has to allocate a physical page frame because it's now missing in physical memory and do the I/O to move the virtual page from the disk into the page frame that it has allocated. And once it has done the I/O is complete, then at that point the operating system can update the page table to indicate now it has a mapping between that virtual page and the physical frame number, which was missing in the original scheme of things. And that's the reason that we had this fault, and we handled the fault by bringing in the missing page from the disk into physical memory, and we update the page table to indicate that the mapping is now established between the virtual page and the physical frame number, and then you can update the TLB to indicate that now we have the mapping between VPN and PFN. And once the TLB has also been updated, the page fault service is complete and life is good. So that's the whole workflow in taking a virtual page and mapping it to a physical frame when there is a miss. Now let's analyze this picture and ask the question, where are potential points of bottlenecks? Now what I'm showing you here is thread specific. A thread is executing on the CPU and looking up the virtual page and translating that to a physical frame is entirely local to a particular thread and local to the processor on which that thread is executing. No problem with that. No serialization at that point. Now moving over here, once the page fault has been serviced, updating the TLB to indicate that there is a mapping now, a valid mapping between the virtual page number and the physical frame number. That is done on the TLB that is local to a particular processor, and therefore it is processor-specific action that's going on in terms of updating this TLB. Now let's come to this middle structure here. This is where all the problem is. So what we have here is the situation where we have to first allocate a physical page frame. That's an operating system function in order to allocate a physical page frame. You have to update the page table to indicate now that the I/O has been complete and now we can have a mapping between virtual page and physical frame. And I told you that the page table data structure is a common data structure that might be shared by the threads, in which case all of these things, what I've shown you here, can lead to serialization. So this is what we want to avoid. We want to avoid the serialization that is possible in allocating data structures, allocating physical resources in order to serve as a page fault. So what we are seeing here is entirely lookup, and that can be done in parallel. No problem with that. Reading is something that you can do in parallel. And similarly, what is happening over here is we are updating the TLB, but it is local to a processor. There is no serialization that's going to happen here. But here, we can have serialization if you're not careful. So as an OS designer, in designing this particular service, page fault service, this is what you have to focus on to make sure that you avoid serialization.